Sickle Cell Awareness Day, and we actually have Miss Etta Pete in studio here this morning, Executive Director at Southwest Louisiana Sickle Cell Anemia Incorporated. Good morning. It's great to have you back.
Good to be back.
Yes, ma'am. And I see that you have a special guest in studio. What's your name, sweetie?
Germani.
Germani?
Yes.
Okay.
A student here at McNeese, at McNeese State University.
Mm-hmm.
I am a sickle cell patient suffering with the genotype SS, which is the most severe genotype.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And so you all actually just came back from a conference, you said, correct?
Right. We went to a statewide conference in Baton Rouge on sickle cell disease, and we had an awesome time.
You did.
And we had speakers from all over the country,
mm-hmm,
speaking to us about sickle cell disease and how to handle it.
Mm-hmm. And the last time that you were here, which was not too long ago, you were actually talking about a camp from children and their families that were dealing with sickle cell. And you were explaining the different types of sickle cell, because what people don't really understand is that there are different levels to the disease. And so I guess, can you kind of, you know, just fill our audience in on what those are?
Right. When I was here last time, I told you that number one, sickle cell is a genetic disease, which means that you inherit the disease from your parents. And we also talked about we have sickle cell SC, sickle cell SS, which Germani just said, which is the most severe type.
Mm-hmm.
We have people who suffer with hemoglobin C, and we also have beta thalassemia plus and beta thalassemia null.
Mm-hmm.
So there are a lot of types of sickle cell disease. At one time, we thought it was just sickle cell anemia.
Mm-hmm.
And so today is World Sickle Cell Day, and what we want everybody to recognize is that this day was established by our National General Assembly in 2008,
mm-hmm,
and it was established to help us to become aware of the disease globally.
Mm-hmm.
It was first celebrated on June 19th in 2000. Today is just for everybody to, what we would like for everybody to do is Google sickle cell disease. Get two facts, share it with a coworker, share it with a friend.
Mm-hmm.
We will be celebrating on June the 24th, which is Saturday, at Mount Pilgrim Baptist Church with an educational awareness as well as gospel music from local groups in the city.
Mm-hmm.
So we'd like them to come out and join us in that celebration.
Mm-hmm. And with her talking about the different types, I know that you shared what your type is. What are the experiences, some of the experiences anyway, that you've had with your type of sickle cell?
Well, being with that I have the severe type, you have what you call the sickle cell crisis,
mm-hmm,
and that is when the sickle cells in the blood vessels, they become jammed, you know, in tight places, say smaller areas like the extremities where I would say the arterioles and our smaller vessels, where they, you know, get small and twisted.
Mm-hmm.
Well, these cells get stuck and jammed, and then they can't,
blood can't flow,
mm-hmm, and then they're not delivering oxygen to those, you know, necessary body parts.
So how does it affect you physically?
Physically, it could mean pain, tiredness, you know,
mm-hmm,
fatigue. Hard to walk sometimes. Sometimes when I'm at school, it'd be hard to walk to classes. So sometimes my teachers need to give me extra time to walk,
mm-hmm,
from class to class.
Mm-hmm. And how long have you known that you've had sickle cell? Is that something that, you know, when you were born as a child, your parents already knew?
Yes. Well, you know, you're tested for it whenever you're born.
Mm-hmm.
Since, you know, 1990. But a lot of people out there I've met that, you know, they don't know. So.
Mm-hmm.
I learned that I had sickle cell when I was in third grade.
Mm-hmm.
That's when my parents told me. But they held it back from me for a little while because they didn't want me to feel like I was any different.
Mm-hmm.
But I've learned to... excuse me.
No, you're fine.
I've learned, you know, that it doesn't make you any different.
Mm-hmm.
As far as, you know, being intelligent and things like that. So it just means that you have limitations that you need.
Mm-hmm.
Physically, you know, being out there at recess and in the heat, playing sports,
I know that one of the stigmas that we talked about, Miss Etta, last time you were here, is people's misconception that you can catch sickle cell. Right. It is, you know, something that is hereditary. And so did both of your parents, did they both carry the gene?
Yes, both my parents, my father and my mother, carried the gene. But, mm-hmm. They didn't know that whenever they had.
And so neither one of them actually suffers from sickle cell?
No, they just have the trait. They have the
trait. Mm. Okay. All right, well, again, we have Ms. Etta Peet. In studio, Executive Director at Southwest Louisiana Sickle Cell Anemia Incorporated. We are celebrating World Sickle Cell Day. Now, is it World Sickle Cell Day or World Sickle Cell Awareness Day?
World Sickle Cell Awareness Day, mm-hmm. But you could just say World Sickle Cell Day. Mm-hmm. But the thing is to let everybody know about sickle cell. Just like you said a few minutes ago, there are so many misconceptions about the disease. You know, so many people they think you can catch it, like we said earlier, but you are born with the disease. Mm-hmm. It's just like you inherit from your parents the color of your eyes, the color of your skin, the texture of your hair. It's the same thing with sickle cell disease. So, you know, we want people to know that you can't catch it. You can be around people with sickle cell. Mm-hmm. The thing that we need to be aware of is whether you carry the gene, if you have the trait. And like Jemana just said, in 1990, everybody was tested. Mm-hmm. But look where we are. Mm-hmm. We're not that many years from 1990. That's why a lot of people didn't know. Mm-hmm. And that they were carriers, mm-hmm. which meant that they had one gene that was a sickle cell.
Mm-hmm. So, and again, today is World Sickle Cell Day, but you said that you all are going to be actually celebrating and having an event this Saturday.
This
and can
Saturday.
You give them the information for that again?
We will be at Mount Pilgrim Baptist Church at 7 p.m. on Saturday.
Okay.
And I also would like to let everyone know, you know, that if you do want to help the cause, you know, the greatest thing you can do is donate blood.
Mm-hmm.
That is one of the most things that we rely on the most as blood transfusions, because we do become anemic. And we require blood when we go in the hospital, so I mean that is one of the most important things that we need.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're healthy and you can and you're able, donate blood if you can, as frequently as possible.
And Jemani, I know that you're Miss Etta's special guest in here today, but you know you seem very articulate in knowing about sickle cell and the disease itself. So do you, since you are a student at McNeese, do you have any sort of support group that it is that you have, maybe with people that are your age?
Not yet, but I do plan on, looking into that in the future.
Yeah.
Right now, I'm a part of Miss Pete's support group.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of our aims, too, is mm-hmm. to work with young adults,
mm-hmm.
Because they're in a transition from when they leave from the pediatrician and go to the regular doctors, mm-hmm. let's say that. There's always a little transition problem,
mm-hmm.
because from birth to 20, I think it's about 20 when the doctors, when you change to adult doctors,
mm-hmm.
then there's a little lull in there with care.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to work with our young adults to get a group. We try, but it's hard.
Mm-hmm.
People need to come forward. If more people would come forward, then we would be able to advocate more for the disease.
Mm-hmm.
And let us know. Numbers is what we need. As well as we need, like I said earlier, if everybody today would just Google sickle cell disease, come up with two facts, share it with somebody, then we will be creating an awareness across the
mm-hmm.
Lake Charles. Let's say, if we just did it here in Lake Charles, that we could get more people to realize that there is a group here that they could come to for support, for not only the clients,
mm-hmm.
but their whole family. We work with the whole family.
Mm-hmm.
Jemani, whole family comes to support.
Mother, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And where again can people reach out to you, Miss Pete, to get more information, to become involved, even to find out more information about this Saturday? What's the best way to get in touch with you?
They can call me at 337-433-2602 or come by the office at 1901 Hollis mm-hmm. Street in Lake Charles.
All right.
Get more information about it, the disease and the events that we have coming up. Also, talking about the blood, we will have a blood drive in August.
Mm-hmm. Blood drive in August. Do you have a date yet?
August 26th, we'll be in a walk for sickle cell. It'll be one of our fundraisers, and we'll be out at Ward 3.
Okay.
The Power Center.
All right, sounds good. Well, of course, if you need any more information or details, you can always reach out to us in studio 491-0966 or the business office 491-9955. We want to thank you, Ms. Etta Peach, Executive Director at Southwest Louisiana Sickle Cell Anemia Incorporated, for stopping by today and bringing Jimani in studio. So thank you for coming.
It was nice to be here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you.
And sharing your story.
Thank you.